Well, hey everybody, I'm Josh. I'm out with the Tree Monster here in Tremont, Ohio. That's Cleveland, Ohio's Tremont neighborhood. Out here checking out these scooters. I think a lot of people know that these scooters came around last year at some point, and then all of a sudden they were gone and disappeared, and not really sure why, but all of a sudden they're back in full effect. Not just the two companies of before, but now there's a third, Spin, Lime, Bird, and Spin. You know, I'm curious as to what happened and why they disappeared in the first place, but you know, I'm gonna see if I can probably download one of these apps and figure out exactly. Oh, hey,
Kevin.
What's up, man?
Buddy, what's going on, man?
Good to see you, pal.
Dude, I'm here with Tree Monster.
Oh, what's up?
I was actually just about to jump on one of these things, but I've never ridden one before, right?
You think it'll fall?
So, well, I think they look dangerous, you know? Not I've that ridden bad. My bike all around. Traffic, downtown, winter, summer, these kind of scare me a little bit.
Really?
Yeah, I don't know why. They look a little top heavy, but
I don't think so.
Kevin, it's actually funny, I run into him because he was the one that was telling me all about last time they were around about the difference of all the models and how there were different companies out there in different cities and all that. You want to repeat a little bit about what you told me about the difference of why different brands are different brands and what you know about them? Well, first, you know what? Do you know anything about why they left in the first place?
They left because the company Bird just dropped them off in the city and didn't tell the city anything. No one, they weren't sanctioned at all. And so the city got mad and just took them back and made them take them away.
Like a brute force attack. Yeah,
and which is understandable, absolutely. And then they went into talks over the winter and in the beginning of the spring and everything and talked to everyone. And that's why now we have three. Instead of last year, we just had the Bird. Right. So now it's able, because we got the one sanctioned. Now we have three total, which is pretty rad.
Well, yeah, that makes sense. You know, I did notice one thing about, since I've seen the scooters for a couple days around driving, a lot wider array of people are riding them. And a lot wider array of people are even like checking them out, age-wise, different types of people, different places. I assume it's because it's now a sanctioned activity.
Yeah, absolutely. Well, that now that it's more like, and it's there. I mean, they were only here for like a week or two last year too, because they were in and out. I mean, they've been here for almost a month and a half or two now. I use them all the time. I don't really like driving very much because it's stupid.
Yeah.
I walk around the neighborhood. I live in Tremont. I walk around the neighborhood all the time, and these, I mean, eco-friendly.
Yeah.
They're great. You know. And they're quick, you know, say I'm going to work, I jump on one, it costs me $1.50. I also got a bad leg, I got a hobble, so that hurts a little bit. This takes pain away from me.
Yeah.
There's three companies. There's the Bird, there's the Lime, and then there's the Spin that we have right here. They're all $1 to start once you get on them. And then each one's different price. The Lime is 17 cents a minute and the fastest. The Spin is 29 cents a minute and the Bird is 31 cents a minute.
So you said the fastest. What's the top speed of these things? Or what's the average
fastest
speed?
There's a speedometer on the Lime and the Spin here, and the fastest I've seen is 13.
Okay.
So I was cooking real fast, you know.
Cooking.
The
that's
Birds
fast.
Feel like they
that's
go a little slower.
Fast, you know?
Yeah, but you don't think about it.
Yeah.
And then you're on it and you're like, well, I'm going kind of quick.
Yeah.
They're super fun. Like I said, eco-friendly was also really, really cool in now day and age with everything going on. They're super convenient. I like them a lot. Like, you know, you jump on it, you see it on a sidewalk, you jump on, you ride it, you put it on a sidewalk. You know, also don't ride it on a sidewalk. Ride them in the streets. You're not allowed to ride on a sidewalk.
Okay,
but park it on the sidewalk.
What about helmets?
They tell you to wear a helmet, but you know.
How many people wear helmets on these things?
I've never seen one person in a helmet, and I look out a window at my job all day long.
I was actually going back and forth all day because I promised my son when I ride a bike I'll wear a helmet. So
right.
I was like, well, I should probably wear a helmet, you know, just in case he sees it. But I never did quite make a promise about scooters. So until we make a deal, I don't, you know.
I think you'll be all right.
Yeah,
I feel like you go a lot faster on your bike than we go on these things.
13. We'll see how it goes.
Yeah.
You know? We'll see how it goes.
So I think you're okay.
I'm sure I'll be nervous for about 2 seconds till I'm scooting straight and I know I'm not wobbling. And
if Elena can do it, you can do it.
Yeah, his girlfriend Elena's been afraid to drive a car, do anything on wheels.
For 30 years.
It's 30 years. She's even
she's good.
Out, so. Well, right on. Well,
let's grab one.
I'm gonna put some information in this phone, and I guess let's jump.
Grab
on.
One.
Show me around how to work them.
Yeah,
let's do it.
Let's do it.
Jump on one then.
Hell yeah!
All right, we're all suited up. We're out of here. First scooter ride ever.
Ready,
let's
Tom?
Let's see how it goes, man.
You gotta kick off. And then
all right.
Throttle, okay?
All right. Well, I'm pretty sure I could probably do that too. Let me strap up, and I better get out of here and catch up to him as well here. So we'll see you later.
all traffic rules must be adhered to.
Trailers for sale or rent. Rooms let for 50 cents. No phone, no pool, no pets. I ain't got no cigarettes. All but 2 hours of pushing broom by the 8-12-4-bedroom. I'm a man of means, by no means king of the road.
Well, that's that.
Did it fun?
I had a blast on these things. They do feel a little bit sketchy when you first get on them, but don't be afraid. You can go as slow, as fast as you want. But it is a nice option to have for, like they say, that first mile, last mile transportation. A little bit of fun too. We always joke about having a scoot. So today we had a scoot, you know. I'm glad I ran into Kevin, helped us out with all the details. He's our resident scootspert.
Scootspert?
So this is Josh.
I don't mind that. There you go, pal.
There you go. Thanks, man. All
done.
This is Josh with Tree Monster. We're out for the next adventure.